As finance minister in 1991, Manmohan Singh was instrumental in bringing the pro-market reforms of that year. As prime minister, the same man and his government now stand accused of ruining the India story, which he once envisioned and kick-started. Here's the full report.
If you continue to follow the course, then the legacy that you left behind will not be the legacy that you left behind as a finance minister. That legacy was different.
As finance minister, Manmohan Singh had deftly ushered in reforms of a state-shackled economy that helped launch years of rapid growth, earning himself a place in history. Now 8 years old and heading into his last months as prime minister before elections, the growth bubble has burst.
Unfortunately, the real problem to me is that the focus of the government and the party seems to be on all the welfare measures and not on the growth measures. It's really a question of what is needed right now or in the next 6 months or even 9 months or a year is to focus on revival of growth rather than focusing on other things which may be important generally and or to the party.
22 years later, it's the same man, the man who is known as the reformer. One finds it difficult to understand why he has become what he has become.
मैं समझता हूँ कि ये government खुद भी जानती है कि भाई इसमें जब हुआ ही कुछ नहीं, Supreme Court की जो ruling आई और उसके बाद licenses cancel कर दिए गए, CAG की report आई और उससे जो है वो पूरे investors का confidence हिल गया, तो उससे जो है फिर almost ठप हो गए ये दो तीन sector हमारे.
The country is saddled with hefty fiscal and current account deficits, and the rupee has fallen like a stone in recent weeks to successive record lows. But Singh, struggling to make his thin voice heard above the din of bellowing lawmakers in parliament, said 2013 was not 1991.
The movement of the exchange rate of the Indian rupee recently has been a matter of concern. The rupee has depreciated sharply against the dollar since the last week of May. There are concerns, and justifiably so, of the impact this would have on our economy.
But a streak of populism threatens to undo what Singh had triggered in 1991. Each time the Prime Minister allowed Sonia Gandhi to dictate policy to him, he was allowing an erosion of his reformist credential. This has been compounded by a policy paralysis that followed a string of corruption charges.
It is these allegations which have ruined the reputation of this government and the personal reputation of Dr. Manmohan Singh. What can the opposition do? What can anyone do? The Supreme Court has come down heavily on this government by saying that the Colgate files have gone missing because the government wants to destroy evidence.
Singh blames the BJP's intransigence for India's slow progress on a second round of deep economic reform and said his reputation was intact on the world stage.
I urge political parties to work towards this end and to join in the government's effort to put the economy back on the path of stable, sustainable growth.
Prime Minister Manmohan Singh has months to go before what the end of his prime ministership. Having brought India back from the brink in the year 1991, the Prime Minister now has a shrinking window to prove himself to the world once again. One can only hope that this time the Prime Minister doesn't need an economic disaster to put his act together. With campus and Krishan Kumar in New Delhi, this is Rishika Barua for Headlines Today.